Hi friends, today we will discuss about RBI, Reserve Bank of India. As you know, all over the globe, you will find central banks. It may be USA, it may be UK, it may be Australia, it may be Egypt, it may be any country around the world. You will find central banking agency. In India, the central bank is known as your Reserve Bank of India. Reserve Bank of India plays a vital role in economic aspect of India. Since British time till today, Reserve Bank of India and its role is well experienced. Let me clarify here, Reserve Bank of India was conceptualized in the year 1934 Act and it was established in the year 1935, 1st April. If you analyze the history of Reserve Bank of India, you will find one commission. That is Royal Young Commission, Royal Hilton Young Commission. So what is Royal Hilton Young Commission? Actually this commission first time recommended for the establishment of Reserve Bank of India. My dear friends, from Indian side, Dr. B.R. Ambedkar, who is regarded as father of Indian Constitution, represented before the commission. In the year 1926, first time one Royal Commission on Indian currency and monetary policy was in force. And first time in the year 1934, it was realized by the experts, by the Indians, in those British time, that India needs a central bank. You people know Bank of England, City Bank, Axis Bank, State Bank of India, State Bank of Mysore, Eco Bank, Canara Bank, many, many banks in India, around the world. What is a bank? Banks not only stands for depositing money and drawing money. Bank is an institution where the economy of an individual, up to a nation, up to the globe, it is determined. And without proper banking, the fate of a nation is meaningless. Without a sound economic system, the fate of any country's economy is vague. So, it is the high time to understand the Central Bank of India, that is RBI, Reserve Bank of India. The first governor of Reserve Bank of India was Sir Osborne Smith. He was the first British governor of Reserve Bank of India in 1935. And the second governor was Sir James Taylor. The second governor was Sir James Taylor. During his time, one important event happened here in India, which changed the entire Indian currency system. My dear, Taylor was the first person to put his signature on Indian currency. So please remember, Taylor was the first governor and the second RBI governor to put his signature on Indian currency. And the third governor was C.T. Deshmukh. And C.D. Deshmukh was the first Indian governor of Reserve Bank of India. So let me clarify, the first governor of RBI, Sir Oswald Smith. Second, Sir James Taylor. Third, C.D. Deshmukh. And C.D. Deshmukh was the even also finance minister, and he also was the main role in the budget presentation. Anyway, now we'll discuss what is the monetary policy of Reserve Bank of India in a very short manner. You see, Reserve Bank of India issues currency. Since its inception till today, if you analyze, you will find number of miraculous things. There are large number of functions of Reserve Bank of India. Number one function is your issuing of coins, minting of coins. As you know, study of coins is known as numismatics. So numismatics, study of coin. So let me clear. First is your issue of currency. Number two is your banker to bankers. It may be State Bank of India, it may be Canara Bank, it may be Eco Bank, it may be all other banks in India. It is the banker to banker. That means RBI is banker to banker. It may be State Bank of India, it may be Canara Bank, right? It may be Eco Bank, it may be, you can say, Indian Bank, right? Any other banks. So it's banker to bankers. Third point, regulating monetary policy. So different mechanisms from time to time is implemented by Reserve Bank of India for regulating the monetary things, the monetary policy. The fourth point is check black money and duplication of currency. Right now, we have read in newspapers regarding the fake currency. Fake currency dilutes the economy, devalues the economy, degrades the standard of economy, and it is a threat to economy of any nation, not only India, throughout the world. And we have to be very careful for those fake currencies. RBI already issued so many notifications for the detection of fake currencies. And most of the fake currencies that is coming to India, that is your 500 rupees for the currency and 1000 currency. And nowadays, it is also found on 5 rupees currency and 10 rupees currency. So anyway, we have to remember this thing, that duplication of currency and detection and how to check it. These are the instructions also given by RBI from time to time to the Indian citizens. Fifth point, supervision of financial system. So any financial system cannot be groomed, cannot be developed, if it is not supervised by Reserve Bank of India, what I mean to say, Central Bank of any country. And what type of supervision is essential, that should be by the government of India, by the experts, by the governors, by the so-called economic professionals, and also the opinions of citizens that can be taken into account for the supervision of financial system. That can be taken as a feedback. And last but not least is your statutory liquidity ratio. What is statutory liquidity ratio? We say this statutory liquidity ratio as SLR. What is SLR? Let me clear. SLR means, that is one type of liquidity. not like water, it is like gold. So in case of this SLR, we have to maintain, means RBI has to maintain a liquidity which is easily, which can be easily converted into money, that is known as gold. And recently RBI has purchased, the government of India has purchased 200 tons of gold from International Monetary Fund. So let me clear here 3 to 4 things, that under section 22, this section is most important. Under this section, RBI issues currencies, that is currencies. It may be 5 rupees currency, right? It may be 10 rupees currency, right? It may be 20 rupees currency, it may be 50 rupees currency, it may be 100 rupees currency, it may be 500 rupees currency, it may be 1000 rupees currency. You see, these are the denominations of Indian currency. And if you analyze this 5, 10, 20, 50, 100, 500, 1000 currencies, Indian currencies, you will find one magic thing. Let me clarify. That if you see, suppose you have 5 rupees currency. So this one portion is known as overs. The front portion is known as overs. The back portion is known as reverse. So overs and reverse. If you see Indian currency 5 rupees, you will find reverse side tractor. 10 rupees reverse side tiger, rhinoceros, elephant. 20 rupees reverse, you will find coconut trees. One beach, you will find reverse of 20 rupees currency. And 50 rupees currency, you will find Parliament of India. That means sovereignty of Parliament is reflected on the reverse side of 50 rupees currency. And 100 rupees currency, reverse side, Mount Everest, that symbolizes the ecosystem of India, how to protect environment, right? And 500 currency, you will find Dandi marks, the father of nation Mahatma Gandhi standing, and all other national leaders are in queue. What I mean to say, Dandi marks, famous Dandi marks led by father of nation Mahatma Gandhi is found on the reverse side of 500 rupees currency. The last one, 1000 currency, Indian currency, reverse side, you will find Indian economy. So 500 is 5 is over 10, 20, 50, 100, 500, 1000. You people may be thinking, what about 1 rupee currency and what about 2 rupee currency? Please remember, 1 rupee currency is not issued or printed by RBI. It is printed by Minister of Finance, that is under Government of India. So Government of India prints, circulates all these 1 rupee currency and also 2 rupee one. But 5 rupees, 10 rupees, 20 rupees, 50 rupees, 100 rupees, 500 rupees, 1000 rupees, even also sometimes 10,000 currency is issued by Reserve Bank of India. However, this 10,000 currency is not in circulation. So please do not remember this one. You people may be thinking, what I am writing here, this one symbol. This is the symbol of Indian rupee. If you see this one symbol, this wala symbol, you will find this is Indian rupee currency. Actually, it is for the differentiation of Indian currency from all other symbol differentiates all other currencies around the globe. And first time this symbol, which is combination of your Roman and your Devanagari script. So let me clear, please remember, this is the Indian symbol of currency. Like you people know, US dollar is like this, right? Even also you will find another symbol like this. So many symbols are there in order to differentiate the currency of different nations, right? So please remember that Sir Oswald Smith, first RBI governor, and C.D. Deshmukh, first Indian governor. First Indian governor. One thing is very important while discussing about Reserve Bank of India, that in Reserve Bank of India you will find one governor and four deputy governors. One governor and four deputy governors. All other officials are there to assist the office. However, the most important thing is one governor and four deputy governors. And without governor, the RBI is meaningless. And RBI is the banker to even government of India also. Whenever government of India is in crisis, whenever government of India is in economic problem, then RBI issues or government of India takes money from RBI by depositing documents, the secured bonds and all other vital things what RBI consider as the security bond, as the, you can say, mortgage. So please remember, Reserve Bank of India is the product of Royal Young Hilton Commission. The brainchild of Reserve Bank of India, Dr. Ambedkar, who is also regarded as father of Indian Constitution. Number three, Sir Oswald Smith is the first Reserve Bank Governor. Number four, under Section 22, RBI issues currencies. Number five, RBI headquarters is Mumbai, and there are 19 offices and regional offices also. And in British time, when RBI was constituted, when RBI was established, the 100% shares, the 100% shares, 100% shares of RBI, 100% shares of RBI, 100% shares of RBI were completely private, But in the year 1949, it was nationalized. So Reserve Bank of India was nationalized in the year 1949. RBI was nationalized. And many students, they confused that RBI was never nationalized. But please remember, RBI was nationalized in the year 1949. And first time, 1969, Indira Gandhi government decided to nationalize 14 major banks in India. And in the year 1982, all other banks were nationalized. And also nowadays, it is a matter of great debate to nationalize all other banks in India. Nowadays, private sector banks are entering into Indian market, like your ICICI Bank, like your HDFC Bank, even also Axis Bank, and also many foreign banks like Citibank, like your HSBC, Hong Kong Shanghai Banking Corporation, even also you can say Standard Chartered banks. So many banks, large number of banks are coming for their business purpose. So RBI has kept the currency, the economy of this nation in order to be a global leader in the near future. Thank you very much. Wish you happy learning. Thank you.